Hello everyone. Namaste. I hope you're all keeping very healthy and very safe right now. And our today's topic of discussion is PCOS, Polycystic Ovarian Syndrome. A lot of women here would be familiar with that term, but in totality, if I have to tell you, it's basically formation of cysts inside your ovaries, and sometimes it may also cause enlargement of ovaries. Now, there are a lot of things that contribute to this disease, but few very common ones are either genetic or environmental. That means lifestyle changes that we have seen over a period of time. A bad lifestyle can also lead to PCOS. So let's talk about the asanas that are my personal favorite, extremely effective in overcoming PCOS, and if practiced every day can give you wonderful results. Let's start with Baddhakonasana. Straighten your legs in front of you. Keep your back absolutely straight. Sit comfortably. Inhale, join your feet. Bring them close to your groin. Now it's perfectly fine. Hold your feet like this. Interlace your fingers and hold your feet. Now it's perfectly fine if you find yourself somewhere here. Eventually, try and keep the stretch active by constantly pushing the knees down. You don't need to necessarily use your hands. Push your knees down and keep your back absolutely straight. Hold this posture for 30 to 45 seconds to begin with. Take it up to 1 to 1.5 minutes. And do it at least 3 times. Inhale again. And exhale, straighten your legs.
Baddhakonasana provides a very good stretch to your entire groin area, to your inner thighs. It's also good for opening up your hips better. It helps accommodation of your reproductive organs better with increased blood circulation, hence increasing the productivity, increasing the functionality of your reproductive organs.
Let's move to Upavishtakonasana. For this, I want you to open your legs wide. They can be somewhere here, or whatever is comfortable for you to open. Keep your back straight. Make sure that your toes are pointed. Inhale. As you exhale, hold your shin, hold your ankle, whatever is comfortable for you. Or you can also bring your hands all the way in the center. Keep your back straight, chest popped out, and nicely just bend forward. Again, hold this posture for 30 to 45 seconds. Take it up to 1 to 1.5 minutes eventually. And do it at least 3 times. Inhale, slowly come up. And exhale, bring your legs together.
Upavishtakonasana also has similar benefits to that of Baddhakonasana. It also facilitates better blood circulation in the entire groin area, and all your reproductive organs stay healthy.
What we'll do next is Naukasana. Now that asana is a little advanced, a little intermediate asana, but it's amazing to increase, to help us build pelvic strength. It also massages your entire abdomen area, increasing the strength of your abdomen, and thereby, of course, increasing the blood circulation in your entire pelvic and abdomen region. Let's do Naukasana. For that, I want you to turn to your side and lie down on your back. Both the hands by the sides. You can take slight support of your hands under your hips. Make sure that your back is nicely pressed into the mat. Inhale. As you exhale, lift your legs. Make sure your toes are pointed. Come into a tabletop position, both your knees together, both your calves parallel to the ground. Now, if you want, you can take slight support of the ground, or you can just gently get up. Keep your back straight, pop your chest out, chin away from your chest, and hands by the side. Hold this for at least 20 to 30 seconds to start with. Try and hold this posture to a minute eventually, and repeat this 3 times. On inhale, you will gently rest your back on the mat, straighten your legs, and slowly bring it down and relax. Let's move to our next asana, Dhanurasana. For that, I want you to lie down on your stomach, forehead on the mat, fold both your legs, hold your ankles. All right. On inhale, I want you to lift your legs, lift your chest, lift your hands off the mat. Make sure that you try and push your feet towards the ceiling. Try and hold this posture for at least 20 seconds in the beginning. Eventually, take it up to 45 seconds to a minute. Do this 3 to 4 times. Exhale, slowly come down.
and relax in Makrasan.
Dhanurasan is extremely beneficial for PCOS because, as you just saw, that your entire body is literally balancing on your pelvis, on your groin. So it really increases the strength of your back, of your abdomen region, of your pelvis, and it massages all the organs that lie in your pelvic and your abdomen region, and it also increases the blood circulation wonderfully. There are certain breathing exercises that we can do which are extremely beneficial in PCOD. First, we'll start with Kapalbhati. Place both your hands in a mudra on your thighs. You can also gently rest your hands like this on your thighs. It's very simple. You take a deep breath and then you forcefully exhale all the air that you've taken in through your nose. And then you make sure that your entire focus is on constant exhalation, forceful constant exhalation. Your body will inhale on its own. So it's going to look something like this. Perform Kapalbhati for at least, start with 2 minutes and gradually take it up to 5 to 7 minutes. If you have high BP issues, then I would really suggest that you skip doing Kapalbhati. Then Bhastrika would be the best option for you. If you feel giddy or dizzy while doing Kapalbhati, open up your eyes, take small breaks in between, stretch a little and then start again. Kapalbhati primarily is excellent for PCOD because it massages the entire abdominal, entire pelvic area, and it increases the blood flow in this area. The next pranayama that we'll do is Bhastrika, which is also very beneficial for the same reasons. You take a deep breath, inhale. And then you exhale the entire air out and you hold your stomach for a few seconds in there, and then you gently release it, and then you inhale again. So when you're exhaling, your stomach goes inside and you're holding it for a few seconds. Perform Bhastrika for at least 2 minutes every day. You can also take it up to 3 to 4 minutes. And if you feel dizzy or giddy or you feel out of breath, take a small break, keep your eyes open, but try and focus on your breath. So all these asanas, if incorporated in your lifestyle, can give you wonderful results, amazing benefits in curing PCOD and a lot of other things also. All the asanas are beneficial to your entire body. Also, please try and maintain a very healthy lifestyle, sleep well. Try and reduce the stress. Stress also has a very bad effect on all the reproductive organs, on PCOS. Try and drink a lot of water and maintain a healthy diet, a sustainable diet. Thank you.